Christina Piper is here with us today, and she has a background in design, but she has transitioned into a lucrative career in commercial real estate. And that's what we're all here to learn about today. So Christina, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
We're so excited. Tell us about your current position with JLL.
Yes, so currently I lead the workplace design group for JLL. It's actually a subsidiary company called Big Red Rooster. So we like to call ourselves the design wing of JLL. We know that space really transcends the human experience. And so ultimately, we like to be champions of creating that space, but also the thought process behind it. So when you look at, for example, a corporate space and you see all the great things in the space, like the colors on the walls, the amazing furniture, the innovative technology. Behind all of that is a very strategic position of understanding workspace metrics and understanding how we transcend an actual functional workplace into more of an experience, or nowadays a destination that people are excited and want to go to. So Big Red Rooster really encompasses everything from that very first conversation on strategy, really to that final check on the punch list when the client moves in.
In order to be able to do this, Christina, in commercial real estate, what preparation do you need?
Yes. So I think many people think this is something that you just kind of fall into, but there truly is a reason to be educated in the art of it. And I went to Purdue University. I got a degree in interior design. I know others that I've worked with have degrees in architecture or brand experience. All these items are really relevant because they not only teach you about the philosophical reasons behind some of these decisions, but also life safety reasons. So, you know, we truly are laying out interior partitions, championing different metrics for furniture, looking at exit clearances, understanding a person with a physical disability, how they experience that space and how they conduct his or her best work day. And so it's really important to realize that this training does occur in a collegial environment where we do look at life safety concerns, and we are focused on metrics that really provide health and safety for the general public.
Where do you go from here? Because you were interior designer, but now you're not as much the interior designer. Now you're directing others. Isn't that correct?
You're correct, Trish. Absolutely. So when I graduated and had my degree in interior design, the next, I guess, correct solution was to start applying that as a designer. So I started at Perkins & Will, where you and I worked together, blast from the past. And I was a designer there. Ultimately, I realized that I really liked the way projects worked, that we could control a schedule and budget, manage clients. So I moved into the project management side, which I know you love as well.
Yes,
we like to keep things organized and concise. Right. And the next step from there was realizing I really liked to manage people, and I really liked to interact with people. And so it wasn't just managing colleagues and learning about the different ways people worked and the successes of those, but really how that transcended into that client relationship and keeping that client, maintaining that relationship and really nurturing it. So ultimately, I went on to lead a studio for interior design, and then found myself at JLL leading the studio here. And so the best parts of my job truly are engaging with great colleagues like yourself at JLL, being able to work together in all facets of what we do at JLL, from property management to project management to, you know, even moving and relocation into design, because it's amazing how all those things work together to create this well-oiled experience that a client truly values. So this is where I found myself now, and I really love being able to be a part of that machine to really define a great client experience.
What other kinds of attributes are beneficial for a job like this?
Great question. Definitely, I know everyone on my team, their goal is ultimately to get certified in their particular area of expertise. So whether that means architecture, being a licensed architect, in our field that happens to be what we call a certified interior designer. And so that requires a certain degree, as you mentioned, years of experience, and then ultimately sitting for a test that allows you to express, you know, what you know about the profession in a very orchestrated setting. So it consists of not only a written portion of the exam where you're actually drawing out a space plan solution and coordinating with different trades like engineers, but also a written two-part exam where it is questioning your knowledge of the industry and of practices that generally we take on in this industry. So that, I'm a huge proponent of that. I do have my NCIDQ certification. I do feel it's a really, really important part of our profession and advancing our profession to really reinforce that we are responsible for the health and safety of the public. So that is a huge benefit. You know, not required in all portions of our profession, but I would say where you're actively producing and contributing to space that people are experiencing, that's a huge piece that we look for our teammates.
Christina, tell us about your day. What is your day like?
Oh gosh, it's all over the map. So I'll give you a few examples. Our team lately has really found ourselves traveling a lot. And this is something actually quite refreshing given the last 2 years of being kind of confined in one spot. You know, our work is all over the US and our projects are all over the US. And during the course of a project, the design phase may require many virtual or in-person meetings. So you may be, if you're in the design phase of the project, you may be constantly creating sketches, preparing presentations, vetting through materials, coordinating with engineers to assure you've got lighting and electrical in the right spots. And then when you move into the actual implementation phase of a project, you're spending a lot of time at the computer, laying out drawings, making sure that you have all the right sets of pieces of information so that when the building department reviews your drawings, they understand that everything is up to code and looking at the life safety, you know, is really important and important that it's done properly. And then during the really exciting time, my personal favorite time of a project, when it's actually being constructed, many times we are on site making sure that the construction is being done in alignment with the design intent as expressed in the drawings, making sure that we are providing, being the eyes and ears to the client on the ground to make sure that that design is exactly the way they envision it when we showed them those great renderings. So the day-to-day life really is a mixed bag depending on where you are in the design process. So I know that that is something my team finds really exciting, is that every day is different and you're never really stuck in a monotonous task of code research. You know, there's always that necessity, but it always ends and you move on.
If someone was going to come to JLL and be looking for a career in this segment of the industry, what kind of roles would they be looking for?
Because JLL now has an internal design team, I would say design should always be a part of that search if that's something you're interested in. But what's also interesting at JLL is that we have a whole occupancy planning team that is responsible completely for all of the metrics that go into huge corporate expansion. So, you know, if you're looking at 1 million square feet and a big campus restack, that information and intel needs to start somewhere with organizing departments, groups, business sectors, business lines, business units. And so that team does an amazing job of the tactical part of that first conversation and understanding how much space are we even looking for? And so that team will work with brokerage to really understand space constraints, planning metrics, for example. Are we looking at shared workstations or desks versus dedicated workstations or desks? That's been a big conversation lately given all the pandemic and are we returning to office and who's coming and when. So occupancy planning is a great avenue for those of you who love space planning and test fits. We definitely do that on our team as well, But if that is your jam, you definitely want to look at some careers in that area. And then I think another avenue that's really been appealing lately is workplace strategy. So we have an amazing team across the country. It's about 20 of us who work with clients to really fashion the metrics around programming and understanding what about the workplace is folding its way into the design from the very early decisions of how much space you're taking. So if you are more philosophical in nature and you really love to understand that human component behind why people select space the way they do, workplace strategy services may be something you definitely want to look into. And then I think lastly, but definitely related to our profession, if you love sustainability, wellness, we have a wonderful team here at JLL who we work with very often, who specifically focus on the sustainability and the wellness metrics of the spaces that we create. So if you are you know, lover of the earth and lover of all things wellness oriented, that might be something that you should look at to really investigate and see if that's the avenue of your career you want to explore. Because all of these things I just mentioned do relate to a degree in design and eventually individuals that go into those different aspects of our profession. So another great thing that we both love of JLL is just the ability to have a degree that can take you in many different areas. And especially I've seen at JLL, the ability to even move within those areas. You could enter your career at one point really loving this one thing, and you start to work on projects and get different experiences, and you find that you've got a whole nother dimension of your career that you want to explore. And I think that's the great thing about JLL is that you can do that here.
One final question for you. What is the most enjoyable part of your job?
The people, absolutely. You know, I have never, I think in my career until I came to JLL, really enjoyed universally everyone who I've come across with, and that includes colleagues, clients, consultants. We really just we're very fortunate to work with some of the best in the world. Our clients really bring that vision to us and trust us to make sure that we are bringing them into this next undefined future equipped with the best intel possible. And we take that responsibility very seriously. So we love being able to shape the space and the experiences that they're having in the office. And we love being able to fuel that intel with real data that we are extracting all across the country.
I love it. Thank you so much. You and I are both enjoying our careers at JLL. And I'm so excited to be here working with you again.
Likewise.
Now at JLL. And thank you so much, Christina, for sharing with us your career and transition from design into corporate real estate and into all things that make commercial real estate beautiful from the eye of a designer. Thank you so much for being with us. And we look forward to watching your career.
Thank you so much for having me. Really appreciate it.